Where I am going, you cannot follow. What's behind Jesus saying, you can't follow me now? Let's read it. Little children, verse 33, little children, yet a little while I am with you. You will seek me, and just as I said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I'm going, you cannot come. Now skip to verse 36. Simon Peter said to him, Lord, where are you going? Jesus answered him, where I am going, you cannot follow me now. But you will follow afterward. Peter said to him, Lord, why cannot I follow you now? I will lay down my life for you. Jesus answered, will you lay down your life for me? Truly, truly, I say to you, the rooster will not crow till you have denied me three times. I see two reasons why Jesus said, you can't follow me now. One is bad news, and one is incredibly good news. First, the bad news. They couldn't follow him tonight because they were morally unable to deny themselves and take up their cross and follow him. Peter, you think you can follow me? You won't even make it through the night. And it wasn't just Peter who failed. All of them did. Chapter 16, verse 32, behold, the hour is coming, indeed it has come, when you will be scattered, each to his own home, and will leave me alone. They were not ready. They couldn't make the sacrifices called for by following Jesus. They needed more power, which they could only get from the fullness of God's Spirit. That's what you'll need when you're tested like this in the middle of the night with swords brandished, ready to take any follower to the cross with him. You will need more than you've got. We need Christ. We need the Holy Spirit. Here's the good news. There's another reason for why he said it. Jesus was about to do what only he could do. You can't follow me because what I have to do alone. You can't do what I'm about to do. Only I can do what I'm about to do. I'm not going to die merely to set you an inspiring example. I'm going to die as a substitute to save you, not inspire you. You can't be your substitute. You have to have another. And that's what I'm about to do. I'm going to become tonight, tomorrow morning, your substitute. Now, the reason I think that's part of the meaning here is because if you just keep reading into chapter 14, watch what he says. I go to prepare a place for you, and you know the way where I'm going. And Thomas said to him, Lord, we don't know where you're going. How can we know the way? And Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. There's no following him, behind him, imitating him tonight. There's no walking beside him, helping him tonight. There's only him going ahead and us going through him. Nobody comes to the Father except through me. I've got that to do tonight, and you can't do it. And if I don't do it, you won't get to the Father. You can't follow me now. I have work to do, and only I can do it.